trigger we are going to see, what is the status of each trigger during a pipeline failure situation. To test that, we are creating three pipelines and we are attaching three types of trigger to each pipeline. So what exactly we are doing is, we are having eight folders in the ADLS, which is the input and output for schedule trigger, storage event trigger, and tumbling window trigger. We are going to upload files to the schedule input, storage event input, and tumbling input. And we are copying the files to the output folder. Now, let's create pipelines for those. Here we already defined six datasets which are pointing to the locations. As this is a tumbling window pipeline, we are going to take the input folder of the tumbling window in the source, and coming to the sink, we are going to take the output folder. Similarly, we are creating three pipelines here. As we created for the tumbling window trigger, we are going to create for schedule trigger. And we are going to define schedule input, schedule output to the sink. Storage event input to the source and storage event output to the sink. Now we have the pipelines defined, and now it's time to create the triggers. Let's start creating with the tumbling window trigger. So we are keeping the interval for every 5 minutes. And if you want, we can specify an end date. Let's leave that as C. And we are going to start the trigger on creation. And let's also create the schedule trigger. And we are going to make it for every 5 minutes. And we are going to specify an end date, which can be tomorrow. And we are also giving the storage event trigger. We are going to point to the folder, which is the storage event input. Container name would be new data. And we want that trigger to be fired whenever the blob is created. We want that for all the files which are inside it. So we are going to give it as storage input with a slash. Now let's attach all these triggers to each pipeline respectively. Now we attached all the triggers to their respective pipelines. Let's try to upload some files and let's check what exactly the behavior. For the first time, we are going to make this a success. We need to make this as a wildcard as we are going to copy multiple files. All the pipelines and the triggers got published successfully. Let's upload few files to schedule trigger, tumbling window trigger, and schedule trigger folders. As we uploaded the files to the storage event input, he is expected to execute the pipeline, and the trigger will be executed. And we have all the files in all the input folders. And we can see the storage event trigger has been executed along with the tumbling window, which is already in the success state. Let's wait for the schedule trigger also to be completed so that we can test that the pipeline and the triggers were working fine. We also have our schedule trigger being fired up. So now we need to make our pipelines to be failed. Let's fail the pipelines just by changing the sync location to a SQL database. We already have the local server with self-hosted integration runtime being configured. I'll also mention the video in the description to how to configure the self-hosted integration runtime to Azure. And now we have published all the pipelines. So let's try to upload some more files for the storage event trigger to make it fine. And let's wait for tumbling window and the schedule trigger. Let's wait until this was been published. And this is published now. So let's upload few files. And we can see here the tumbling window trigger has failed, failed state. And we can also see for storage event trigger, even if the pipeline is failed, the trigger run will be successful. And we can see there are two files in which we uploaded and two status is in succeeded. And whereas for the pipeline runs, both will be in failed state. And the schedule trigger was also being executed now. And as expected, the pipeline must be failed. And coming to the trigger runs, it will be succeeded. And we can see the schedule trigger, the status is in succeeded. And coming to the pipeline runs, it will be in failed situation. As a summary, we can see that coming to the triggers, even when there is a pipeline fail situation, we can see only the tumbling window trigger will be in failed state, whereas storage event trigger isn't succeed, and also schedule trigger isn't succeeded.